It is. Plenty of time.
Thank you.
Friends, we are gathered together in the sight of God to witness and to bless the joining together of Lori Middlestad and Jerry Lamczyk in Christian marriage. The covenant of marriage was established by God, who created us male and female for each other. With his presence and his power, Jesus graced a wedding at Cana of Galilee, and in his sacrificial love gave us the example for the love of husband and wife. Lori and Jerry now come to give themselves to one another in this holy covenant. To Lori and Jerry, I ask this question. I ask you now in the presence of God and these people to declare your intention to enter into union with one another through the grace of Jesus Christ, who calls you into union with himself as acknowledged in your baptism. Lori, will you have Jerry to be your husband to live together in holy marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live? Jerry, will you have Lori to be your wife, to live together in holy marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live? The family members gathered here, I ask this question. The marriage of Jerry and Lori unites their families and creates a new one. They ask for your blessing. Will you support them in their union and pray for God's blessing upon them? Will all of you gathered here, by God's grace, do everything in your power to uphold and care for Jerry and Lori in your marriage? Let us pray. God of all peoples, you are the true light illuminating everyone. You show us the way, the truth, and the life. You love us even when we are disobedient. You sustain us with your Holy Spirit. We rejoice in your life in the midst of our lives. We praise you for your presence with us, and especially in this act of solemn covenant through Jesus Christ our Lord. A reading from Paul's first letter to the Corinthians. If I speak in the tongues of men and of angels, but have not love, I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. If I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains, but have not love, I am nothing. If I give away all I have, and if I deliver my body to be burned, but have not love, I gain nothing. Love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous or boastful. It is not arrogant or rude. Love does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrong, but rejoices in the right. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. The word of the Lord. From the scriptures, we hear the Apostle Paul's words about the way of love, words intended not only for Jerry and Lori, but for each one of us here this morning. Paul's words are particularly appropriate for this day, though, for marriage is a relationship which uniquely and intimately consists in love. The essence of marriage is a relationship of love. Paul's description of love in 1 Corinthians is full of beautiful language and beautiful imagery, and is probably a familiar text for many of us. But often when reading it, I suspect a good many of us probably fail to hear a lot of what Paul is really saying about love. What is love? What is love like? He says, love is patient. Think about how difficult it is to be patient. Love is kind. Love isn't jealous or boastful. It is neither arrogant nor rude. Love doesn't insist on its own way. Love isn't irritable or resentful. Love doesn't rejoice at wrong, but rejoices in what is right. If you really listen to what St. Paul says, you may realize that love is going to require some work. Love is effort and commitment and faithfulness. Love is a certain disposition, an attitude, a way of life. At least as Paul describes it, love is really so much more than warm fuzzies, despite what our culture might teach us. Love is so much more than just feeling as if you're in love, good as that may be, because love goes much deeper.
Love is a principle which brings things together in a caring relationship and holds them together throughout both good and bad. Joseph Campbell writes that marriage is not a simple love affair. It's an ordeal. And the ordeal is the sacrifice of ego to a relationship in which two have become one. And St. Paul Well says, love may ask you to bear all things, to hope all things, to believe all things. But the good news is that Christian faith teaches us that as we struggle and grow together in love, as we give ourselves in relationships of love with others, we then can discover true and meaningful and abundant life. And even more so, we discover that it is with the same kind of love that God also loves and struggles with each one of us. A patient love, a kind love, a love which will bear and endure all things, a love which is fundamentally self-giving. It is the same love which is mirrored so well in marriage, the very love we celebrate today. Jerry and Lori, we pray that the gift of God's patient and kind and forgiving love will be the model for the marriage we formally begin this morning. And on this, your wedding day, we pray with you that by God's help, you may fulfill God's good and loving purposes for the whole of your earthly life together. Let us pray. Eternal God, creator and preserver of all life, author of salvation, giver of all grace, bless and sanctify with your Holy Spirit Lori and Jerry, who come now to join in marriage. Grant that they may give their vows to each other in the strength of your steadfast love. Enable them to grow in love and peace with you and with one another all their days, that they may reach out in concern and service to the world which you love, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Jerry, take you, Lori, to be my wife, to have and to hold, from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, until we are parted by death. This is my solemn vow. In the name of God, I, Lori, take you, Jerry, to be my husband, to have and to hold, from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, until we are parted by death. This is my solemn vow. These rings are the outward and visible sign of an inward and spiritual grace, signifying to us the union between Jesus Christ and his church. Bless, O Lord, the giving of these rings, that they who wear them may live in your peace and continue in your favor all the days of their life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Terry and Lori, you have declared your consent and vows before God and this congregation. May God confirm your covenant and become your donors with grace. Now that Jerry and Lori have given themselves to each other by solemn vows, with the joining of hands and the giving and the receiving of rings, I announce to you that they are husband and wife, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, those whom God has joined together, but no one but asunder. Let us pray. O God, you have so consecrated the covenant of Christian marriage that in it is represented the covenant between Christ and his church. Send therefore your blessing upon Jerry and Lori that they may surely keep their marriage covenant and so grow in godliness together that their home may be a haven of blessing and peace. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Now let's all pray together with confidence, saying the words our Savior gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Jerry, Lori, may God the Eternal keep you in love with each other so that the peace of Christ may abide in your home. Go to serve God and the neighborhood of all that you do. Bear witness to the love of God in this world so that those to whom love is a stranger will find a new, generous friend. Now may the blessing of Almighty God, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be with you now and remain with you always.
Jim, this your case?